7:43. He almost forgot. Oh, I did it. And we're just in the nick of time.
There it is.
We're back. It's serious business.
Yeah.
Here. We're talking Jurassic World, Fallen Kingdom, Familiar Prayer. I'm curious to hear what you have to say of how they reinvent this franchise once again.
Yeah, well, they don't. You don't need to sell me on the dinosaurs, but you need to do a little bit better than this. Jurassic World, Fallen Kingdom. It starts as a dino rescue and turns into a vast conspiracy. Have a look.
Get in!
The shot of the T-Rex is just right out of the end of the first one 25 years ago.
How many scenes, or how long in this movie are there scenes without words and just screaming and dinosaur roars?
There's a lot. Yeah, I'd say probably two-thirds of it. This is not a good movie. It's dumb, frankly. And the magic's gone. I remember 25 years ago, I was 13, and we were impressed when a Brachiosaurus got up on two legs and reached to the top of the tree and got some foliage and then came crashing down. The whole theater rumbled. That was good enough for us then. Now, it's just that's not going to appease the masses, so they have to come up with all kinds of wacky plot points and just jam all the dinos in, but there's no mystery or suspense or tension anymore, despite the handsome-looking trailers.
Any silver lining with the cast, Chris Pratt and crew, what they bring to the screen?
Bryce Dallas Howard's okay. Chris Pratt kind of sleepwalks his way through. All the characters are so thin and poorly developed, it's like a cartoon. And I know it's a dinosaur movie, but even this strains credulity. Like, there's a part where Chris Pratt's got tranquilized and he's trying to outrun some lava, and he's like inches from it, and he's flopping around like a rubber man. And it was like Kingdom of the Crystal Skull type stuff. I was like, really? Descended into the self-parody that I always feared it would. I'm not surprised it's gone this way, but I'm kind of sad because the original, it had this intelligence, it had this prestige and the storytelling, it had these great concepts and themes and tropes that it wrestled with. Now it's become just schlocky summer B-movie fare. And you may just want that out of your Jurassic World movies, but I feel like they ran out of ideas. And there's all these callbacks and nods to images and scenes, just like that one from the first ones, and I just felt like they had run out of ideas. And don't even get me started on the extended Jeff Goldblum cameo. He's just mailing it in. It's just sad.
Even Jeff Goldblum can't save it.
No way. And it's such a blatant setup for the next one. It feels at the expense of this movie's plot. And the big thing is they have this Indoraptor, which is a mix of the Indominus Rex from the last one and a raptor. So it's this really intelligent raptor. That's all they got.
Are you mad?
Yeah, pretty mad. I mean, there's lots of eye candy, and it's got a lot of action, but that's about it.
How many hammers?
The dinosaurs were better actors in this one than the humans.
Ooh!
Yeah. Strong showing from Blue the Raptor, and the T-Rex was decent. 2 out of 5!
She still gave it 2 after all that, eh?
Yeah, a little generous with the dinos.
Such a nice guy. Yeah. All right, proceed with caution.
Don't do it.
Jurassic World.